Welcome to This Ready to Craft. In this video, I will show you how to use Ready Board foam board to make a decorative dressing screen. To begin, I'm going to trim down my foam board into equal sized panels. I chose to make each panel 16 inches wide. Keep in mind that you will need a total of 4 pieces for each assembled panel, a top front and back, and a bottom front and back. In total, I used 16 pieces of foam board. I will also trim a little away from the top and bottom so that my edges are perfect. I'm going to measure 2.5 inches from this edge. And I will measure 5 inches from this edge. I only marked 2.5 on the other side because when I combine the two pieces together, the total center width will be 5 inches. Finally, I will mark 3 inches on the other sides. Using my ruler as a straight edge, I will cut the center out. I will set aside the foam board I removed for future projects. Prepare the rest of your panel pieces the same way. Grab 2 of your pieces, as well as white glue and masking tape. Line up the 2 thinner edges. I'll use a little piece of tape to keep them from shifting before laying a strip across the entire seam. Flip the panel over. Lift the seam to expose the edges of the foam board and run a line of glue along the inside. Then use a scrap piece of foam board to smooth out the glue that oozed out from the seam. Allow that to dry before flipping the panel back over. Carefully peel away the tape. I'm going to run a thin line of glue along the seam and smooth it with a scrap piece like I did before. Follow these steps for all of the panel pairs. To keep myself organized, I mark which pairs I intend to glue together. Because I plan on using spray paint, I need to protect my exposed foam edges. To do this, I'm going to use Mod Podge. Make sure to get the interior and exterior edges. You could also use foam primer spray. Once that is dry, I'll take my pieces to a well-ventilated area to paint them. I find that multiple light coats of spray paint produces the best results. With my pieces painted and dry, I'm going to add a clear protective layer. This will also add a little shine. Be sure to test any clear coats on a scrap piece first. In total, I applied 2 coats to all of my panels. While those dry, I'm going to cut my fabric pieces. The windows of my panels are 10 inches wide, so I'm going to cut my fabric at the 12-inch mark so that I have an inch on either side to adhere to the glue. To cut 4 fabric pieces. I'm going to lay the fabric out on one of the panels. I'll use a generous amount of white glue around my window. Pinning the center, being very careful not to puncture through the foam board. Then I'll press the fabric into the glue and adjust it to make sure it is pulled taut. Fold the other side over and glue down as well. Once it is dry, I will remove the pins and trim away the excess I have at the top and the bottom. Then, use lots of white glue to attach the panels without the fabric to the back of the ones with fabric. For me, this process took up a lot of floor space, so I don't have footage of it. I used some books to weigh down the panels and allowed them to dry for 24 hours. Once they were dry, I got my pins and ribbon prepared. I'm going to use the ribbon to cover the edges of my panels. I'm using white glue because I like having a little extra working time to adjust the placement, but you could use hot glue for this as well. Once that has dried, I'll move on. I'm going to use some decorative ribbon to cover the center seam of my panels. To attach my hinges, I'm going to measure 15 inches from the bottom and the top and use masking tape to mark the points. I will line up my hinge and let the other half wrap around the edge. I'm doing this so that I keep a little gap between my panels so that they can move easily. I'll mark where my holes go, and then remove the tape to be used on the rest of my panels. Length of the screws that come with your hinges. Mine were too long and would have gone through the back of my panels, so I had to purchase shorter ones. I like to puncture a little starter hole where my screws will go. I'm going to use glue in addition to the screws to keep the hinges in place. I recommend marking all the points for your hinges first, and allowing the glue on each pair of hinges to dry before attaching more panels. If you try this craft out, we'd love to see it. Our social media links can be found in the description. Don't forget to like and subscribe. If there's a foam board craft that you'd like to see a ready to craft of, let us know in the comments.